Hey, what's up artists, I'm Jonathan, and in today's video I'll be going over the process of importing and using heatmaps in Godot. A handy plugin is provided that allows us to create terrains in Godot in seconds, but there are some workarounds we have to go through to get the best results possible. And with that said, let's get started. Before we import a heatmap into Godot, we of course first have to create one, and for this I'm using Terra Sculptor, which is a free terrain generator program. So let's go to File, New Project, and I'll use a resolution of 2K. For this video, a very simple height map will do the trick. So let's go to Noise Map, select Gradient, and the one I like most is Rough Mountains. We can now play with the sliders to get a terrain we like, and after that click on OK. To make this more interesting, I'll quickly go to Erosion and simulate rain erosion. Alright, that's done. It seems like it's a bit too harsh, but it will work for this tutorial. We now have to save the heatmap in a file format we can easily use in Godot. And this is going to be PNG 16-bit grayscale. So let's go to Export Terrain, choose a folder, and let's name it Height, and choose PNG. Click on Save, 16-bit grayscale, and click on OK. Now, we quickly want to set up our Godot project. Let's click on New Project and give it a name. Click on Create Folder and create an edit. Now in Godot we have to create a 3D scene, but before we do this, let's import the heatmap plugin. To do this, let's go to Asset Library and search for Terrain. And we'll be using the Heatmap Terrain tools by Zilan or Zilan, I personally don't know how to pronounce this name. Let's click on it and choose Download. Once it's downloaded, we can click on Install, Install, and you can see that Godot is importing all of the assets. Let's click on OK, and a new folder has been generated. To actually use this add-in, we have to enable it. So let's go to Project, Project Settings, Plugins, and check Enable. Great! We can now proceed and create a 3D scene. With Ctrl and S, let's quickly save it. And now, to add in a terrain, we want to press Ctrl and A and search for H terrain. Now, with this selected, click on Create, and you can see that the terrain node has been added as a child node to our spatial node. But right now, we get an error and we also can't see any terrain. Let's click on this error and it tells us that a data directory is needed. To add a data directory, we want to click this folder icon right here, create a new folder and let's call it T underscore data for terrain data, and choose select current folder. And just like this, terrain has been generated. Awesome! Of course, this right now is just a simple plane, and we want our height map to affect the geometry. For this, we want to drag and drop our previously exported height PNG image into our directory. And you can see that it was imported as PNG. So now, with the terrain node selected, we want to go to Terrain, choose Import Maps, and choose our PNG image as the height map. Let's click on Import, and the height map is taking effect. But you might be able to see a problem, and this is that Godot imports PNG images only as 8-bit. And you can see that in the import settings, there isn't an option to change it to 16-bit. And this results in banding in our height map. And of course, this is not what we want. So we need to convert our PNG image into an EXR one, because Godot can natively import EXR images, and the terrain add-on can also read EXR images as a height map. But there is a little workaround we have to do, convert it correctly. The brightness values in our PNG image are between 0 and 1, but the height map plugin expects greater values in an EXR file, so we need to remap these brightness values. And we can easily do this in Blender. So with Blender open, let's switch to the compositing workspace and click on Use Nodes. We won't render anything, so let's delete this Render Layers node. And now with Shift and A, search for image and add in the image node. We can now open our height.png image and feed it into a Map Range node. We now want to remap the values between 0 and 1 to 0 and, for example, 250. With the Viewer node, we can view the image And because we can only display values between 0 and 1, almost everything will be white. But this is okay, we now just need to select the viewer node, go to item, save this image, and save the new hide image as OpenEXR. And with the EXR file saved, we can also drag and drop this one into Godot. And it has now been imported, so with the terrain selected, let's go again to import maps, and now choose the EXR file, and click on import. And you can see that the brightness values are interpreted differently from PNG values, because the terrain now isn't as high as before. But you can see that all of the banding disappeared, and we now are left with a smooth terrain to work with. And yeah, that's basically it. This video was just a little quick tip on how to import height maps into Godot. If you found this video helpful, consider liking and subscribing, and we'll see each other in the next video next Saturday.